The man right here in studio. So Matasi, for you, you know, of course, you know, many people have talked about what, you know, the amazing saves, especially in that game against Senegal. Most people, even if you look online, they're talking about the amazing saves you did. What do you think was the challenge in terms of, you know, whenever, because even Swila here, as we were watching, like some of those actually, ile kusema kweli, because I believe you had a team talk, kuna time defense tu ilikuwa imetuangusha.
Okay, hatuwezi sema ati defense ilituangusha. Ilikuwa ni collective thing.
Okay.
In terms of defending and attacking. Najua. Once team inatembe kama block, tunaenda wote one side, tuna shift the other side, depending ball iko wapi. Naona. So hatuwezi sema ilikuwa ni defense. Ilikuwa ni collective thing na ilikuwa ni the 11 players wenye tulikuwa kwa field. Because most of the time, coach alikuwa ana-analyze kila mchezaji. Anasema huyu anakimbia hapa na wakati wako na ball, huyu anakimbia hapa. Like Tarifa with the Tanzanian first goal. Tukiwa pre-match talk na coach, alisema bwana Samata huwa anafanya nini, when they have counter-attack, he always pull the defense and end wide. So always watch what happened. Tulikuwa na set piece on the other side. They won the ball, katikati. Bwana Samata akakimbia wide. So before a defender a turn, na the difficult thing is hakuna situation mbaya kama defender could defend while facing post yake, unaona. So when Bwana Samata alipata hiyo ball, alikuwa direct. So alikuwa shabit au fullback, na by the time to react alikuwa shatumaliza. And the same thing coach aliongelea kwa
Kaputok.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So ukiangalia, there are some things coach anaweza ongea, mostly zina happen and zingine zina happen, you see. So one will happen kama yoga ya Tanzania, unaona, if tunge track huyu jamaa mapema hata to make foul pale nje ingekuwa different thing. But tuli slick kidogo, then we defended facing our post, na hiyo ni kitu most of the defenders have pained. So inakuwa easy if defender ana defend while facing the field kuliko wakati ana defend ana face post yake. That's why.
And going into that game, come for example, you are Tanzania,
yes.
What was the mood like? Because there was so much pressure. This is what, even as the commentator alisema, East African derby, Diamond akatoka akatoa wimbo akasema kanyaga, but I don't think he was referring to the game. But still, how much pressure did you guys feel even on that game? Was there na muliji psychology?
If you look at the Tanzania na Kenya, we are close countries. So hii game ilikuwa imeongelewa sana. And then ukiangalia pia, Kenyans were saying, hakuna vile Tanzania wanaweza tufunga. So pia sisi, hiyo moral pia ilikuwa. But ukiangalia vile sisi tulianza game, the first 15 minutes, haikuwa, hatu kwanza poa. Naona? So wakati game inaanza, lazima team tukue compact. But sisi, so hiyo hype ya Kenya, Tanzania ili tuingia. So wakati tukua tuna attack, hatukua tuna kumbuka kuja kudefend. So after hawa jamaa kupata bao, li equalize. Then wakakuja tena wakatupiga ingine. Naona? So ikakuwa 2-1. But when tulienda dressing room, after coach kuongea, sisi wachezaji 11 wenye tulikuwa kwa uwanja, tulitanda tukasema, majama, afadhali tufanya kitu ingine, lakini hii game lazima tuishinde. Naona? So ilikuwa ni game yenye ilikuwa imeongelewa for like 3 days. So hakuna vile tungeiluzi hiyo game.
Okay. What do you guys think about you know, the performance? I know even watching it, you're like, sometimes there was some defensive mistakes, you think?
Definitely. You know what Minye said, and even he said his numerous press conferences in Cairo, was that injury to Brian Mandela and Joash Onyango left him in the defensive crisis, because to him, Mandela is the leader of that defense, and he said it several times. So had Mandela been fit and Joash Onyango, definitely he would have used 3-man center backs, yeah, like what he used in the qualifiers. But that means he had to change the defensive formation. Joseph Okumu, a young defender, he did very, very well, very promising. But now, we made a lot of defensive blunders. But again, if you look at the formation we used, the 4-2-3-1, I think we did Olunga a lot of injustice, because we could see him struggling to get the balls. Many a times he had to leave his workstation, shift either wings to try and get the ball. So when you're having your lead striker pale mbele, that shouldn't be the game plan. Mm. And you saw it even against Tanzania in the first half, we struggled. Then he opted to go for the 4-4-2, bringing Avire to partner Olunga. Mm. Immediately we piled a lot of pressure on the Tanzanian defense. We turned the game heads on and won it. Now, shockingly again for me, the final game, which we needed just 1 point to go through, we again went back to the 4-2-3-1. But we held very well for 62 minutes. We just needed to be brave for 28 minutes, get that point, and we are through to the last year. But after getting that goal, conceding that goal, we just buckled under pressure. Right now, I know, focus shift to Chan. We are going to Dar es Salaam, and it's going to be a tough game because having beaten them in the AFCON, definitely they are waiting for us there. And a good chunk of the squad you saw in Cairo are based at home, save for Mbwana Samat and two, three other guys. Most of them are at home. Now, we are going to that Chan. The likes of Matasi won't feature because he's playing professional football. And that large chunk of starting 11 of Menye won't feature Olunga, Wanyama, Timbe, and everybody. So, and Kenyans are waiting. The fans are waiting. And I hope Menye is going to qualify us for the Chan finals, failure to which we are going to see fans screaming for his head. But I hope the squad is going to have, will Kenyan give the best. And remember, Alan Wang again, who was left out of that squad, albeit, has also retired. Menye had planned to use him in the Chan squad. But with his exit, we are going to see what Menye is going to do in the coming days. I expect him maybe hold a press briefing and tell us how prepared he is for that game. But it's going to be very, very tough, mostly in Dar es Salaam.
Mm-hmm. All right. In the meantime, also, I just need to remind you guys of our question of the day. We're asking, who do you think, in your view, I see already so many comments, who do you think will win AFCON between Senegal and Algeria? Who do you think will win? Nickname Senegal and Algeria, Nakonga?
Desert Foxes.
Foxes and the Lions. The
Lions of Teranga.
So, the lion, will they be outfoxed or will the Lions roar? Hashtag to use. Is Daybreak Hazard or Pulisic?
Pulisic.
I'll use it.
I'm a Lampard.
Lampard. Cheza chini kwanza.
Sawa.
Anzia kwa usifike
huko. Wing.
Usifike kwa bench. Ama nijiweka huko. Anyway, what do you think about the gaps, especially now that we are moving? What can Menye improve on?
I think Matasi kuna kitu hata sema, but the point is we were really failed by the coach because you see, as a coach, when your plan A fails, have a plan B.
Usikuwe, this is your vest theory.
Theory.
Okay.
Usikuwe mtu wa kutoka kwa nyumba bila vest ndani. Unaweza tolewa shati pale nje, ubaki naked. So the point is, I could refer the Harambee Stars situation to what Sarri took Chelsea the whole season last season. Because Sarri ungeka ukae chini unajua squad yake ni gani na anacheza na anacheza formation Nazim gani. Mm. And in this case I'm referring to the injury Harambee Stars got ya Brian Mandela na Joash Onyango. These are part and parcel of a game, a football game. Na coach angekaa chini angalie, alikuwa na provision ya 23 players. Kwa kila number alikuwa na option ya wachezaji wawili wawili. So kwa position ya Mandela, alikuwa na Mandela na alikuwa na provision ya mchezaji mwingine. Ya tuseme Joash alikuwa na the same provision. So ni coach ambaye angekaa chini angalie, if Mandela my dependable defender ataumia, What fallback plan do I have? And in this case, tunaongelelea Chan, ndio utakuta, because Brian Mandela plays his trade in South Africa, he will fall back to Shakava. So that is such a defender I'm talking of, angekuwa na yeye kwa plan, after Mandela uko na Shakava. A very huge, towering, same characteristics.
Sani kama mimi hivi.
No, but physically ako tofauti kidogo. So ndo nasema the same characteristics angezipata kwa Shakava. I wonder why Menye alidrop Chidi Akumu. To me, he's a versatile player. Anaweza cheza kwa defensive mid, he can fall back as a defender. So those are the options that the coach missed. And to me, Matasi was the defender and the goalkeeper. Mutu asikudanganye kwamba first half ati tuli contain Senegal. Matasi kept us into the game. So mutu asikuambia ati tuliwa contain. Look at the blunders we made against Tanzania. Defensive blunders. Very clear defensive blunders. Angalia Musa Mohamed vile alikuwa naachwa na Mane. As a defender, those are very, very, I can call them... simple mistake, sitaki kutumia maneno ambayo yata demoralize team, but those are simple mistakes that should not be made in a defense. Una expose your goalkeeper, and most of the times Matasi was exposed, but he rose up to the occasion and saved the team. Were it not for Matasi, let me tell you the truth, Senegal ingetuchapa mabao saba, Algeria ingetuchapa mabao saba, Tanzania ingetushinda by 5 goals. So to me, the man of the tournament for Harambe Stars was Matasi. And now going into CHAN, this gives our local players a chance to prove themselves. Wale players, wenye watu wengi walipiga kelele kwamba waliachwa, this is their time. Matasi and the team saved our face in Cairo kwa kuchapa Tanzania. Now the local team is headed to Tanzania. What can they do there?
The renewed rivalry.
It's renewed rivalry. Yes. So it's another ground that imekuwa warmed up to bring up the rivalry. Mm-hmm. So again, as Kenya na vile tuko, we cannot afford to lose against Tanzania. So the local players, akina Avira, I think he will be leading the attack. Na the likes of akina Harun Shakava, they should pick up from where Matasi left and represent us well in CHAN. But what we wait is, wacha tungoje coach akona strategy gani.
All right.
Na tuambia nini.